What's up, guys? Middle-Aged Gamer here. We're playing Transport Fever yet again. This is going to be a no-nonsense walkthrough on how to complete the Great Depression mission right here of the America campaign. So we're going to go ahead and get into it. Let's click on Start. And this mission has given me a lot of hell. I've played it probably 6 times before I actually figured out what to do. And I'll kind of explain what not to do and what to do here shortly. So again, you can read all this. The voiceover is turned off right now, so it's not going to read through everything. Let's go ahead and start the mission up. So our goal is to export fuel, as you can see, 5,000 fuel. So we need to get oil down to this plant right there and then bring the fuel down to the harbor to basically export it. Quite a few things that we have to do in this mission. I did a lot of things wrong the first couple of times. I just had hundreds and hundreds of trucks moving goods to Houston, and I'd always get the importer gold medal, but I would never be able to export 5,000 fuel. Well, the problem was I was exporting most of the fuel that was made here to the cities all around instead of actually exporting all of the fuel just down to the harbor here. So I'm going to show you exactly what to do. Click on the question mark in Houston. Do not purchase the patent for $15 million. It's ridiculous. Run the risk. And then all we're going to do is we're going to open up the oil wells in San Antonio, which is basically my hometown. And it's $3 million to open up each well. Just kind of keep an eye on how much they have at each well. So that's pretty good, $2,000 in San Antonio. Let's look at Dallas. Only $500 there, which is not very good. And $2,000 there, which is really good. So we do need to connect the roads on the outer two most oil wells. And we'll connect one over here in San Antonio. Again, if you haven't played this mission, try to go ahead and play it one or two times before you watch my video, because this is gonna be a walkthrough of what to do. And so, next step is we need to set up a truck depot for here, or truck station, I should say. We'll do a large truck station. Just make sure that that plant lights up, and then we're going to connect a road right here to avoid traffic. And we need to set 2 drop-off points for San Antonio oil and Dallas oil, so let's go ahead and build 2 bus stations real fast. And I'll show you a little trick that I've been doing. We'll put one right there, and we'll put one right there. Here's a little trick to avoid traffic from all the trucks going into the factory. Just build a little loop around your bus station, and I'll show you why here in just a minute. I'm also going to set up a road right here for future purposes, and I'll show you guys why I did that later on. Alright, so everything's looking good so far. Let's add the truck depot, or road depot, I should say, not truck depot. And you could build one up here, you could build one down there. It really doesn't make much of a difference either way. In fact, I'll just put it right here. And we're going to set up 4 different lines for the different oil wells real quick using the Mac AC, because the running cost per year is a little bit lower than the Ford. You can probably use the Ford without an issue. But I'm going to set up 5 vehicles for each line initially. Oh, and one thing before I even do all that is I need to set up truck stations at each of the wells. So let me do that first, actually. That would probably help. That way the oil gets put into the station first. Let me do the 2 up in Dallas real fast. And we'll go over the gold medals here in a little bit and how to obtain them. But we're going to be getting all 5 gold medals in one run through. That's what my videos are all about. So don't worry about watching an entire hour of video only to get 2 or 3 gold medals. I'm going to show you how to get all 5 in one go through. All right, so let's go ahead and set the lines up in... I don't know why it's making my mouse do that. That was crazy. It was like stuck scrolling right there. Anyways, let's go ahead and set up the line from San Antonio West all the way down here. And I'll show you my little trick right there with the loop. You can see instead of it going all the way to the factory and back, it's just going to loop right after it drops it off. Very, very important that you do that, in my opinion. All right, let's go ahead and set up the second route. Again, you could probably do more than five vehicles initially if you really wanted to. It's not a big deal. A lot of people name their lines and get really OCD with it. I'm pretty lazy, so I'm not going to name the line. I'm not going to make them wait for a full load to deliver any oil. You could do that as well if you really wanted to. It's not a big deal either way. All right, so two of the lines are set up. Let's go ahead and set up the other two. Again, it's going to loop back around. There we go. And we got one more to set up. All right, so that one's good as well. Now, what we need to do is set up the line that brings the fuel to actually export it down here. So what we need is a bus station. Put the bus station right there. And for this route, we're actually going to use the Ford models, which hold just one more, but they're a little bit quicker. So I'm just going to buy two for the time being until we get the fuel moving a lot more. And we'll have them drop off there. All right, next step is going to go ahead and upgrade the shipping terminal. This is kind of the mistake I made previously. I didn't use any ships. Wrong. If you don't use ships, you're not going to do this mission properly. I was using hundreds and hundreds of trucks to the point where I upgraded all the streets. All the trucks were backed up, delivering stuff. And I still didn't export enough fuel. Again, mainly because I was bringing the fuel from here to all the different cities. I was bringing fuel down here, but not enough, quickly enough to do the mission properly. So we have a shipyard over there. We need to go ahead and set up a shipyard in New Orleans because part of the thing we have to do, and if you want to click on here, it will tell you why. We need to ensure that New Orleans is supplied with sufficient goods from the port of Houston to be able to use this oil rig to get oil in the future. So again, let's go ahead and set up the shipyard over here. This one's a little hard to set up just because of the steep hill right here. But we shouldn't have an issue. Let's go ahead and get it right. Let's put it over here a little bit more. There we go. And the first thing I'm going to do is set up a truck depot. There we go. And then we need a road going up to the city. Very, very expensive road because of the tunnel, but go ahead and do it. It's not a big deal. And then we need a place where we're going to drop off the goods, which if you look at the city, we need to drop it off to the commercial district. You can go and put it downtown NOLA. It's not a whole lot of traffic either way. And then we need another road depot over here. And we're only going to buy one truck for the time being to run the route. And we'll go ahead and use Ford, the Ford model over here. Again, not a big deal. We'll have to add more trucks once we start having lots of goods delivered. And it'll just go from the truck station right there to downtown NOLA to deliver goods. And then we need ships as the next step. So let's go ahead and hit play since we have most of the routes going. We need to go ahead and set up a shipyard. Try to put it close to the depot if you can. And then we need a freight. So you have two different freight ships. One is just for solely transporting crude oil, oil, and fuel, which we don't need right now. So the only option to transport goods, which this one does, is the Klondike. Go ahead and buy that. Nice $500,000 spent on one ship. And we'll set up a line from Houston Harbor Docks all the way to NOLA. Oh, you know, I made one mistake there, and that's a big mistake, too. I put in a passenger station, which you do not want to put in the passenger station. Let's go ahead and delete that. We need a freight or cargo harbor. Hopefully we can put it right where the other one was. We'll find out. Is that connected? Hopefully it is. And we can go and upgrade that to three terminals too, since we're here. There we go. Now let me go back to the boat and see what it was on. So line 8. Okay. Going from Houston Harbor Docks to NOLA. I don't know why the game... Ever since they updated the game, it's been kind of lagging slightly in certain areas. So let's go ahead and hit play, make sure everything is working properly. I do want to make sure that goods gets delivered here to the harbor. That way the ship can actually pick it up. And you just want to make sure that all your trucks are going the right way, which they should be if you set up your lines properly. and make sure you don't have any warning messages. If you have a warning message, typically it's because a route's not set up properly or a line's not set up properly. Let's go ahead and speed this up just a bit. We're not going to worry about exporting any goods to the city quite yet. I want to make sure that the harbor has goods loading first. And I did click on, so we got to deliver 40 goods to New Orleans. So nothing's coming up at the harbor quite yet. It might take a little bit before it does, though. Alright, so all the trucks are headed out, which is good, to different ports. I could probably do another road depot over here in case I need to buy more trucks on this side. Again, it's not very much money for a road depot, so I'll just put one there for future purposes. And while we're waiting for this to get going, let's go ahead and open up another oil well. And I'll show you guys why I put that extra road there here in just a moment. I want the road to come off here. That. There we go. It's more like it. Again, do shorter sections to save money. That way you're not building tunnels or digging into the ground too much. All right. Let's see that one comes out like that. So I could have spent $650,000 just going over. So it's very important you build it in shorter sections to save money. There it is, and we need a truck station over here. And this is why I built the extra street over, so we can have another loop with the bus station over here. So put it right there, and then we'll put the road looping around. That way, the different trucks stay off each other's path. So let's go ahead and buy 5 more Mac ACs. I think that's 6 right there, but not a big deal. There we go. And we should have goods loading at the dock pretty soon. I'm not sure why there's not already. Let's look at our line down here and make sure everything is good. Yeah, so that's lit up, which is what we want. And we have goods being delivered, so we have to station there. Let me set up one more line to make sure that everything is set up correctly. Put another station right there, and let's add one more truck. Hopefully that's the problem. Alright, let's see if we got goods being delivered yet or not. And it's saying to export goods, which we definitely need to do. The problem is the goods should automatically be loading on here. So let's try this. Let's get rid of that truck station. And let's see if we can make a closer connection somehow. I didn't mean to delete that. Let's try to reset it up though. That's a waste of money. All right, that's definitely highlighted, so let's see if we can upgrade this. And then we need to add or change the line 8. Let's see if goods start getting loaded there or not. buy a couple more ships. Hopefully that makes the demand for goods at the harbor. We'll see here in just a second. Again, not a whole lot of oil quite yet to deliver to the factory to make the fuel. That will all increase over time. All right, we have goods being delivered now. I think we just needed more ships going. All right, that's about time. That's good. That's a relief right there. Not sure why it didn't load initially. Maybe you have to have so many ships going on the route. And I'll just turn these ships around every so often to make sure we get plenty of goods. The question is, can I cram another truck station in there for the export process? I can actually put it down here. In fact, we don't need... In fact, you'll never need this right here, so get rid of that. There we go. That's what I need. And to start the process for the importer, we need to go ahead and start importing goods to the city to make sure we get that down the road. We're on the right track now, which is very important. And I'm going to go ahead and buy a couple of trucks to do that. I'm going to set a line from the truck station, and we need to set a terminal in the commercial district right here. There we go. And that's going to start importing goods there. We need to upgrade line 6 trucks, so we probably need to add a few more Fords on line 6. Let's go ahead and do that real quick. And that guy has goods, this one doesn't. Let's go ahead and turn this guy around. Oops, I didn't want to turn that guy around. One turned that guy around in a second. What's this guy doing? Turn around. Okay. Had me nervous. Didn't really want to, this is kind of a bad start to be honest with you as far as the shipping of goods, but at least it's going, that's what matters. Another thing you do for the importer goal, in fact, let's go ahead and do this real quick, I'll tell you guys that in a minute. Let's add a couple trucks to, is there any lines that are producing a lot of oil? Maybe out here. Let's add a couple trucks to line 2 real fast. Should be good for now. All right, so importer, 6,000 goods. Let's go ahead and put a couple stations in Beaumont and Lake Charles to see if those do any good for the importer. Again, we need them in the commercial districts. These are small towns, though, so really one bus station covers the whole town almost. And let's go ahead and put that one right there in Lake Charles. And then we also got to do is set up the lines. We'll just put a couple on each set line from there to over here. And we'll do one more. And from there to Lake Charles over here. And that'll just help get the, importer going. So let's look at the metals real quick while we have it in fast time. Busy pumpers is probably one of the hardest ones to do. You have to export 5,000 fuel before 1955. Investment never exceeds 75 million. We won't have any problems with that. I love spending money, so not a big deal. Oil baron, we have to produce crude oil from all the wells located in the land. So we have most of them. We have 4 more to go. That's not an issue. Like lightning, we got to make a train route from Houston to New Orleans, and it has to take a maximum of 5 minutes, which we'll go over that here in a little bit, and import at least 6,000 goods via the Port of Houston. We'll go over that in the future as well. So we got plenty of goods here waiting for us. We may have to add some more ships in a little bit, and we're about to deliver our first 50 goods, which will meet the deliver goods criteria, and it'll actually open up this port down here in a little bit. Only problem with the boats is they are insanely slow, as you can see, but they make plenty of money once things get going. And we're going to kind of take all the goods at once. In fact, I'm going to go ahead and pause this guy right here. Have him sit outside the port until he can get a full 100. This guy's basically full, so he's good. Let's look at the oil wells, see what we have going. Is there any ones we can add trucks to? So Dallas Oil Well 2 has 2,000 total. Let's go ahead and add a couple on line 4 since we'll have plenty of oil coming from that in the future. Buy a couple more max. Set it on line 4. I think that was line 4, right? Let me make sure. Yep. And we'll release this boat once it gets closer. And this is the trainer that we're going to be using in the future. It's a combination train, which I'll go over in a little bit when we set up the train route. I'm just waiting for this lonely guy to get to New Orleans before we can start buying some oil ships. We'll probably buy one or two oil ships to transport oil from the rig here to Houston. At 68, let's go ahead and restart this guy. There we go. By the time it gets in, there should be about 100 in port right there. I wish they had a bigger cargo ship. I don't think you get one till later on in the mission, and by that time, it's not even really needed. All right, let's see what this guy has. He's at 84, 85. So, yeah, should be close. Get about 100 on the ship, which is what we want. And then we'll start buying more ships because you can see it takes a long time to get there. Good. Full ship going out, which is what we want. So there's plenty of stuff that needs picked up on line 11, which I believe is this one. Yep, line 11 to Houston. Let's go ahead and buy a couple more just to make sure we get that metal. I don't want to buy too much because I don't want to clog the entire system with just line 11. Literally, you could buy 40 trucks right now and just have a complete pile up in Houston, which I definitely don't want to do. Something that would be a good idea would be to upgrade the streets down here if you can. Especially the one going into Houston, probably a good idea. Just make sure you're not deleting any buildings. Let's go upgrade this guy. Can't do that street. It's kind of weird. Huh. All right, not a big deal either way, I guess. All right, so goods in the harbor getting close to 100. Let's go ahead and buy another Klondike real quick and set the line to line 8. Make sure it's going to Houston first. I guess I set that up in reverse for whatever reason. And we're close to delivering the goods, which will unlock the oil rig. So the next step is go ahead and buy a ship, the Vandal right here. I think it's a passenger. Yeah, it's a passenger boat right there, so we can't even use that. Let's buy the Vandal, though. And let's set the Vandal up for its maiden voyage. It's going to be a new line going from the oil rig, if I can find it, back to Houston Harbor. I guess I could have ran a train line. You probably could have used that depot right there, run a train line straight to Houston right there, back and forth, to get that importer goal. We're not going to have an issue as we are right here, though, so I'm just going to leave it running. All right, so that ship's full leaving. We still don't have any ships returning, so we're probably going to have to buy two or three more. That way there's a constant flow of ships going from port to port. And we need to run a couple more on line 6, it looks like, coming up. So Dallas Oil Well has only 360 more available. Don't want to run too many trucks to that. Line 4 has quite a bit of trucks running to it for Dallas Oil Well 2, which has 2,000. So let me go ahead and add a couple more to line 4, probably 2 or 3 trucks. Okay, so those are going good too. All right, so deliver goods, which is going to open up the oil rig out here. I don't know if you have to upgrade those terminals for any reason or not. I'm going to go ahead and put it on 3, though, either way. We definitely need to add another ship before I forget. Make sure it's going to Houston first. We have to add one or two more too, more than likely. We finally got some return ships coming though. It almost has 200, so I might have to go and buy another ship. Again, make sure it's going to Houston. Look, there's already 100 goods there, so it's good. I bought another ship back to back. Quite a lot of oil on line 4. Might be a good idea to buy a couple more trucks for that, since that's probably one of the biggest oil rigs we have going. All right, let's go ahead and add these other oil wells real quick. And we're going to do basically the cheap route, which is running the lines all the way around. You could build a bridge. Let me see how much a bridge cost, because that might be the best option. About 4 million. Yeah, might as well. Make things a little bit easier for us. Take out the loan. Sure, I'll take that out, no problem. We'll go ahead and slow down time so I don't miss anything either. Set up the truck depot. Don't need a big one, just a small one's fine. And we'll go ahead and unlock these guys as well. Truck depot here. And we've got 2 more. Let's go ahead and connect these two. We'll add the other two here in just a second after we do this. One. Let's go ahead and set up the other one real quick. There goes. I have to buy one more ship here in just a second for that route. And let's go ahead and speed things back up again. I think line 6 is good. We're exporting good amounts of fuel. I really want to try to get to maybe 1945 with getting close on the exporting fuel, so hopefully we're on track for that. What's wrong with road vehicle 81? What is wrong with no path? Line 15. Why is there no path? Oh. That would help if I connected the street, right? I should have looked at the lines closer when I was making it. There we go. Now let's try that. Warning's gone. Trucks are moving. That was my bad. I should have looked at the line, or the street, and the line when I was connecting, for that matter. Didn't do it. And let's go ahead and buy probably one more ship here in just a minute, because we don't... Okay, there's our returning vessel. So we basically have a constant flow of ships going, which is making quite a bit of money for us, as you can see. Next thing we probably want to work on is unlocking the other two oil wells, and then we'll work on the train line from Houston to New Orleans here in just a second. Let's go and buy one more ship, set the line again. Line 8. Make sure it's going to Houston. Oops, I don't want to change the name of that, but I did. Is the oil guy working? I don't know why the oil guy is not working. That's kind of strange. It may be because I don't have... Well, that's including... Let me try one thing. I'm going to set up a bus station on the industrial section to see if that will start it up or not. And let me just add one truck on it and see if it works or not. So I'll have it go from here to here. I need to add a couple vehicles for line 6. Not sure why this hasn't started up. I'll give it a few minutes to see if it starts. If not, I'll try a couple different things. Let's go ahead and unlock these other two oil wells and get this going, though. Needs another depot. And then we'll unlock this one over here as well before setting up the lines. There's a couple different ways you could do this. I just do road networks. You could technically have all these wells going to a shipyard right here and then ship the oil over. I think it's easier just to do roads, though, in my opinion. Slow time down just a little bit so I don't miss anything. And this is going to have to go basically all the way over. It's going to be a long trip, but it's not a big deal. And let's set up a road depot over here because going from all the way down there takes way, way too long. Again, just buy a couple more Mac ACs. Go from there all the way down there. Oh, I need to set the station down here. All right, let's see if the oil's going yet or not. Nothing waiting. That's not a good sign. I know I had it going last time too, which is kind of a bummer. So let me try one more thing. I do remember doing this last time, which shouldn't have to do, but we'll see. Turn production off and then back on after a little bit. Someone turn it off. And then back on. Let's see if that does anything whatsoever. I don't know what happened. This didn't get any goods, and goods are not coming on the harbor now either. Did I mess something up along the way? That has goods. Oh, that would be why. That's a big mistake. Not having enough goods on line 7 or line 10 going out. Yikes. So let's fix that real quick. That's a rookie mistake right there. Take out our last loan right there. So these guys, let me see what line these guys are on real quick. Line 7, I need one on line 10. There we go. Wow, that was my mistake, 100%. I should have been removing those goods. Let's turn this guy around. This is saying it's still not connected for some reason, and I have no clue why. Let me look at the line, see if I can just redo it, maybe. I don't think that's going to work, but... you know, it may need to go... I know what it is. I think I need a line taking the oil up there, is why. Now it sounds ridiculous, but I think that's my mistake too right there. So it'd be going from here on up to drop it off. Let's see if that works real quick. Okay, we're making goods at the port again, which is very, very important. Rookie mistake right there. My bad. I should have had these guys removing the goods way, way quicker. I probably have way too many trucks now, but it is what it is. We're not really... So I need to get this line up. Line 6 is very important. Let's go ahead and do more trucks on that. And let me see if I can just wait till they're full. Let's see. It's probably gonna slow people down, but still wanna wait. Kind of like real life, just ship sitting out in the port waiting for a full load to go. And I probably need to get rid of some of these trucks that are running nothing, but definitely set up too many on each of the lines. I was in desperation mode. Leave the rest for now. All right, full ships going out, which is what we want. We're exporting fuel, which is good. Probably start running a few more trucks out if we need to. Let's see up here, line 16. Do a couple on line 15. And line 19 as well would be good to add a few trucks on. Oops. There we go. And line 18, we'll add a couple more on that. That should increase the oil production quite a bit right there. This guy's still not getting any crude oil. I'm not quite sure why. Let me try sending him to New Orleans just to see what happens, if that will do anything. Didn't have any problems doing that last time, so it's kind of weird. Because I have one truck running up there to drop off oil for no reason. So let's remove that. Let's add New Orleans, which I don't think is going to make any difference. I feel like the game's just kind of messing with me right now. So where's fuel? It's line 11. I have to sell that boat eventually. I don't know why. Last time I played this, I had two or three of these oil tankers going back and forth delivering stuff. So I don't know if it has to do with the truck station being filled up, which it probably does. Let's see how this city is set up. I wonder if I can just literally run a train station right there. Anyways, I think now is the time to set up the passenger train station. In fact, what I may do is once I hit 6,000 goods exported or imported, I may just get rid of this line altogether with the trucks. I'm not sure how I'm doing on that. I wish there was a number to figure that out, but there's not. And let's go and do the passenger line. So we've got $16 million to play with, which is quite a bit of money. Do passenger route. We'll do a end station. And let's do four platforms just for future game. And I want to run a high-speed track. We're going to run it right through the mountain, too, which is a really expensive way to go. But it's the right way to do it if you want to get under 5 minutes on the travel time. And pay for the upgraded bridge. You see we're spending millions and millions of dollars. And actually, I want to go ahead and set up the New Orleans. Train station before I get going. There we go. Let's see, I did the... Let me pause. I need to add more to line 6 real quick before I get going. Could be the rightmost, which would be the leftmost coming this way. Make sure I get this right and don't jack that up. Looks like we need $25 million to set that up. That can't be. I feel like there's got to be a cheaper way to do that. Let's run the line this way and see if we can get that down. So is that $25 million? Yeah, that looks more like it already. That's only $7 million. There we go. This is going to be the expensive part right here. So I need about $8 million before we can connect that. Let's go ahead and speed it up and wait till we get some more money. Because we're on our last loan, unfortunately. Fuel down there. Start exporting as much fuel as possible. I'm going to add a couple more on that line. Things are going good. You can see the oil. There's plenty of oil at each station. Just leave it at that. You could add a couple more trucks on each one if you want. I can definitely add trucks to this because there's 2,000 total, at least 1,300 total now left. So I need to add a couple to line 4 to increase that. There we go. Let's see if this oil guy is doing anything yet. Nope, still not. So I'm just going to send him home. I still got one truck running back and forth for no reason right now, which is not a huge deal, but... You see exporting fuel is going up quite a bit. I may have put too many trucks on here. Now let's see if we can upgrade these streets just a little bit. It's getting kind of claustrophobic. Doing okay so far. Just need a couple more million to finish up the train line, and then we'll add a train in a little bit. I guess we can go ahead and do the train depot. Let's do that. There we go. We actually build that. I want to build it. Okay, so we got it. That's it right there. Now we need right at $5 million for the train. I just think we'll probably be there in no time. So we got a good system of ships. I don't know how many ships we got. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9 total. Which they all seem to be running pretty good. Good source of income. This train's actually going to be a pretty good source of income too. Let's go ahead and slow down time. We're going to set up the bus stations real quick for Houston area. So let's get the bus stations out. Put one close to the train station there. You could probably get away with just doing the residential areas if you wanted to. But it's not how I like to do things. Let's go ahead and add another road depot. A little bit closer. And let's buy a couple. Oh, we don't have the nice buses yet, unfortunately. We'll do the Schneider, I guess. Let's do a new line. There we go. This one's going to go from here all the way down here. Gonna leave the industrial guys out of it, or industrial section of the town. Now let's go and set up the other city in New Orleans. Got the bus stations first and foremost. Put one right by the train station. Probably just do the residential areas of here for now. Over here as well. All right, let's go ahead and add a few buses. Sell those guys off. Second line as well. Going back and forth right there. And speed up time because we need to be able to buy a train, which we can't buy quite yet. Getting very close though. Of course the twin coach becomes available right then and there. Wish I would have had those when I was building the route, but not a big deal either way. Definitely exporting quite a bit of fuel. Not exactly as much as I would like to, but I think a lot of the fuel is going into this depot. Unfortunately, but we're doing okay. Not a big deal either way. We're about to sell this ship right here. Unfortunately, I can't transport oil. I'm not sure quite why it's not working. Shouldn't make any difference for our mission, though. Let's get rid of you. That'll help me buy a train. Very close to being able to buy the train I need. So, what I was talking about the train is in, you can actually buy a locomotive and then buy, of course, passenger cars if you wanted to. The best option for this case is to get the... was it Zephyr or Zephyr, whatever you want to call it, Pioneer. It's just a multi-unit train. It holds 52 people, but it's very, very fast. You can see the top speed's 110 right there, which is important. We're pretty close to being able to buy it, so wait till I get above that 5 million mark. Probably the next ship that comes, I'll be able to get there. I'm going to add a couple more trucks on line 4. Might need to add a couple more out here to 15. And line 16. Just increase the fuel production a little bit more. Okay, let's wait till we get the 5 million. It's gonna be our next step. Do I need to buy another ship? Could. We'll let it go, though. Almost halfway at 1942. Still not doing very good, or as good as I would like to do, but again, I think it's because I started the import. I should have just waited on that. But we're still on track to get all 5 gold medals. This is not going to be the way I really wanted to get it. Alright, so we got the money to buy the train. Let's go ahead and buy it. And very easy, just set the line up to go back and forth from Houston to New Orleans. And let's just follow it one time. You guys got something to watch, so looking at the map overall. It's pretty cool how they have the crossings on the roads right there. Really neat. And it will take a while for the passengers to start waiting. Luckily, there's already passengers waiting, but it'll take a while for the train to start getting full. Actually, there's no passengers yet, it looks like. Usually it'll take 1 or 2 passes between the 2 cities to start really filling up and making money. So just plan to lose a little bit of money on the train initially. I'm gonna keep that open to see how fast it gets going. Very, very expensive line to build. I mean, millions is what we spent on this track, but it's well worth it. It's already up to 73. And the only thing I didn't do, which may actually help on the speed, is making the stations. I think you can make the stations actually high-speed track inside, but oh no, it's going 87, 88, 89, 90 miles per hour. That's pretty good. Not bad. We already got passengers waiting right there. Almost a full train, 46 people, which will make plenty of money. Let's go ahead and back out and see how we're doing over here. About halfway on the exporting. I might want to add a couple more trucks to line 6. I had a couple trucks on line 4 again. Lake Charles Oil Well 2, 674. Let's see what this one is. Jackson, we can send some to Jackson, which is line 19. Let's go ahead and do quite a few to line 19. There we go. This is not getting backed up either, which is good. It's a good reason why you split up the bus stations. Obviously, this station has the most traffic going back and forth, but there's such a big distance in between all the oil wells. You really don't get backed up there. Then you could build airports if you wanted to right now. It's really just a waste of money. But what's not a waste of money is to build more track and also more trains as well. I don't know why it's not connecting right. There we go. Want to follow this track all the way around. That way it's a little bit cheaper. Again, you could connect the tracks before the tunnel to save a lot of money. I'm not going to do that because we want to be basically spending money or as much money as possible. There's always a train collision usually in this area. There it goes. Fixed it. Not sure why it does that sometimes. Alright, so I need some more money before I start building any more track. So line 11 is really what you want to ramp up. I want to kind of wait. Is it fuel? Yeah, fuel is what we really need to get rid of. I want to wait till the new trucks come out. I don't think they've actually came out quite yet. No, they haven't. So I'm going to wait for that before we start buying any more trucks for that line. If you look at the routes, you can see what's the most profitable is. There's probably one or two routes we can completely get rid of at this point. Yeah. Most profitable is the train as of right now, which is pretty crazy. And then the ships is next most profitable. And of course, you got the oil and the fuel. All right, let's go ahead and finish that second track. Is there a terrain collision? There shouldn't be. Alright, well, it's connected to this track then. How about that? Does that work? Alright, that works. Kind of wasted a track right there, but not a big deal. Alright, so that's the truck that I wanted right there, the Studebaker. Let's go ahead and pause it. I'm going to add some to line 11 real fast. There we go. And let's fix this track too. I want it to go on the other way. Need to be put on this side. Go. Now he's got to wait for another 5 million to buy that other train. In fact, I do need to upgrade line 11. Let me look at the vehicles on here. I guess I could do it individually, which would be a pain. We'll send all these guys home and upgrade them here in just a second. Left. Before we do that, let's add the train. Oops, there we go, there it is. There it goes, got two trains running now. And once he's got to get to the depot, I'll go ahead and sell them and get some more trucks moving. Pretty good on exporting fuel, so we have until 1955. We've got 10 more years to go. We really need to work on the importer. So I'm going to add line 11. Let's see what else we got. Line 12 for fuel. And line 17. Well, line 17 was the other one. For fuel, yeah, line 17. What else do we have as far as goods? That's the other one, right? Line 11 for goods. Actually, line 17 needs more. There we go. So far, things are going good. Exporting fuel is really getting up there relatively quick now because we've got so much oil coming in to the factory. You see we're producing 460 right now out of 800. And again, this will upgrade over time if you watch it. It just started with the building. Now we have more refineries there. Quite a bit more traffic though too, which is the negative part. There we go. So we got the importer metal already. Let's see what else we need. Like lightning, we've got to work on the Houston-New Orleans route. We're not going to exceed 75 million, and we got to finish before 1955. So yeah, we're easily on track for that. I don't see any reason why we make it. There's going to be quite a backup right now, only because I just bought all those new trucks. And plenty of goods going out. So the only thing I really couldn't figure out is how to get the oil from the rig to here, which this is one of those things, man. It was working last time I did it. I don't have any clue why it's not working right now. Let's go ahead and build another train. Again, you could run multiple trains on the two tracks that are here. Oh, I'm going to have to actually get rid of that. Make sure there's nothing in it first. Making plenty of money right now. Let's see if this works about getting me, or giving me a collision, I should say. There it goes. Alright, so far so good. The last part may be kind of harder to do. To give us an issue on that. And let's go ahead and get set up to buy another train. So I need to delete that. I'm just going back a little bit more. There it goes, and we are running out of money. There we go. Got 2 million. About to say, we might have to get the little in-game message that comes up. Even if you get the in-game message that comes up saying you're out of money, don't worry about it. It's not a big deal. As long as you're profitable overall, you don't have to end it. I could technically add more trucks to line 6, but they're doing just fine. And again, we're easily on track to get 5,000. As far as I can tell. You know, I might just end this all together since we already have the importer. I know it's worth a lot of money, which really sucks, but I'm going to get rid of this all together just to make sure we get to 5,000. Well, yeah, let's go ahead and do it. Let's get rid of it with all the lines. Line 11, vehicles. Is there any way to send them all home? I know there is, just don't know how to do it. Actually, we could change these over to line 6. We'll send all these guys home. We're solely going to work on the export fuel. Same thing with all these guys, just get rid of them. Go to home, we'll sell them all. Which one am I missing? There it is. Come on, 20. Let's get rid of these vehicles too. You can see it's just gonna ramp up on the export fuel like crazy. So I think for some reason when you dump fuel off here, if it goes into the depot, it doesn't actually count. So we just fix that basically. Oop, gotta get rid of all these guys. In fact, I could probably change these over to line 6. Be definitely overkill on line 6, but not a big deal either way. So these guys need to go home. We can go to line 6. This guy needs to go home. There we go. Again, definitely overkill on line 6, but you can see we're getting up there in the amount of exporting fuel that we have. And we need to buy another train, it looks like, for that third line. Wanted to have the export fuel by 1945, but it's one of those things. We're still definitely on track to do very, very well on this. I'm not too concerned with it. And why we still have that? Oh, because we have a vehicle on there. Let's send him to line 6. How about that? There we go. Now there's no more warnings. Let's go ahead and add a fourth track here. Again, this is definitely overkill as far as how many tracks is going from city to city. But I just want to make sure we get that next achievement for under 5 minutes. Let me try to upgrade this station real quick to give us some more track to work with. Upgrade, high speed. There we go. Not sure why I didn't put the platform as high speed to begin with, but I should have done that. There we go. Gives us our fourth track right there. Let's go ahead and upgrade the other station to high speed as well. Again, not sure why I didn't do that. There we go. And then we'll set up this for the last track. We got 3 trains both going the same way at the same time. Let's turn one of these guys around. Any of them have passengers? Nope. Alright, almost got the export fuel. Yeah, we definitely have overkill on line 6, so... That guy needs to go home. Making sure they're all fuel trucks hauling fuel. That guy needs to go home. This guy needs to go home. Same with you. I'm not sure what depot they're actually going to. That's the next question. Probably this one. Nope. Hmm. Which depot are they going to? That's kind of crazy. Guess it's not a big deal either way. And now would probably be a good time to actually set up a train line to transport the fuel back and forth in bulk, but too late for that. We're already at 4,600. Where should these guys actually hold 13 as opposed to 8? Actually get another boat right now. Might as well spend some money. Alright. Let's go ahead and buy that fourth train, get that going. That guy's full, which is good. Means it's making some money. Probably set up a few more taxis or buses, I should say. Oh, that's the depot where everything's at. Go ahead and sell all those guys. There we go. Buy a couple buses. Let's see. One of the last lines that we set up, right? Line 21. All right, that guy's full. That guy has 4 passengers already, which is good. I don't like how these guys are actually in unison. One has 40. Pretty awesome looking though. That's awesome. That guy filled up. That guy had 12. Let's go ahead and stop this guy just for a second. And we'll let him go once that guy gets a little farther forward. There we go, got the export fuel. Now we got to worry about the Houston to New Orleans journey time, which we have plenty of guys going. Let's go ahead and release this guy. Spread him out just a little bit. And we're going to get a bunch of warnings for replacing vehicles. Don't worry about it, it's not a big deal. Should have a bunch more coming of those. And having these 4 trains set up should easily get us the like lightning. And then, of course, we'll get busy pumpers and investment once it's all said and done. If you wanted to, now's the time to do a 5th track. I might as well. I got money I need to burn. Let's see if I can upgrade this guy by any more. And let me get rid of this. Upgrade. Go. Let's start spending some money again. frozen frame rate right there trying to lay track. There we go. Burning money that we need to. And let's see if we can upgrade this guy. There it goes. Actually, I need to upgrade it again, don't I? There we go. No, it's not gonna let me, is it? Why won't you let me? I have to delete that. Alright, so we got like the lightning. And that should be, I think, pretty much in the scenario. We still had 5 years to go. Or I was waiting for all the 5 journey times to take place. That might be the second journey right there. We need 3 more within 5 years. That should be pretty easy right there. Zero passengers. So how many you got on you? 0 passengers. We should get the end screen here any second now. Probably once this guy hits the station. I'm gonna say probably the full train going back at 52. If I need to spread these guys out more. That frequency is already doing pretty good. Let's keep it going instead of spreading them out right now. If I have problems, I'll stop one and there it goes. Alright guys, that's it for this particular mission. This one gave me a hard time when I first started it, so hopefully this helps you guys out. Still don't have any clue why my oil ships weren't picking up oil from the rig, but it's not a big deal. Again, we had 4 more years to go right there, so you got plenty of time to do this mission. You could have added more trucks to the oil route to deliver oil quicker. And I would wait to do the importer or the exporter, whatever that trophy is, or the importer trophy, until you actually export the fuel, because it goes a lot quicker. Once you do that, then you can set up the routes to Houston and other cities to do the importer gold medal. It'd probably be the best way to go about it. Or you could just follow exactly what I did and easily, as you can see, get all 5 gold medals at once. Anyways, guys, feel free to follow me at youtube.com or subscribe below. Or you can check me out on twitch.tv/middleagedgamer. And I'll see you guys next time. Cheers.